Good afternoon. Allow me to welcome you from Krasnahorka. That's my advantage and disadvantage also. Well, a lot of information has been already said by the other panelists, so I'll be short. Maybe I'll skip some of the slides because I think it has been already suggested, and I would rather focus on some specific issues, for instance, carbon footprint and so on. I would skip this first slide. Well, it's a question mark. How the ideal model of management should look like? Somebody think it's like family business, family farms. Somebody thinks crop grown somewhere in the middle of the sea. But I think that especially speaking about cattle breeding, the model of the Czech Republic is quite good. Thinking about discussions about the cattle, why people think that cows kill the climate? Well, I have to laugh about it because a lot of populist claims were used, not exact scientific measurements. So I would like to focus my paper in this direction. So partially, I will share with you the studies from abroad plus the research project in the Czech Republic. So I think it's necessary to discuss it. We all talk about carbon footprint. I think maybe it's discussed too much. So here we see the number of dairy cows in Europe. And of course, you see it in the Czech farms. Speaking about the structure of Czech dairy farms is ideal. In fact, less than 2% cows are in stanchion-tight stable, and 98% of cows are in the modern open stalls with a lot of light. You can use the welfare robots, especially when milking cows, and you have information about individual animals. And here in the table, you see the size of our herds. So 70% are from 200 to 1,000. Cows, which is ideal, I think. So speaking about production of milk, well, in the Czech Republic, we are third in the efficiency. 96% of the dairy cows are registered and their production, which is the advantage of Czech farmers, because I have to say we got a lot of technicians, highly qualified ones. They studied it about in the high schools or universities. So I think that we have high know-how in the area of animal husbandry in the Czech Republic. Definitely, we have good living conditions of animals. Of course, not only the best of the breed, the best farms are not included in the registry, but I think that cows are living in good conditions with appropriate care. So then one of the lowest consumption of antibiotics, top quality of milk, one of the highest quality in Europe. And we can see it also in the interest of foreign dairy manufacturers from abroad. They are interested in Czech milk, buying milk also for cheese production and so on. So a few information about My company, we have about 5,200 hectares of agricultural land, primarily animal husbandry, yeah, because hardly we can compete in plant production. So you can see it from slides. About 17 hectares of cereals, 400 hectares of rape, and 1,300 hectares of feed. So this is, of course, the background for the cultivated land evaluation. We have about 4,120 cattle, so we have two farms, 800 dairy cows in Krasna Hora Farms, milking 9,371 liters, the breeder C and then breed H in Petrovice with 703 pieces of cows. We are delivering 15,430 of liters. We are also delivering to Madeta. So, definitely, they produce most cheeses from our milk. Then we breed 400 pieces of the BAMS breed. So I also wanted to highlight that we try to use to maximum extent our own feed, not to depend on the import. So especially in peas, clover, alfalfa, rapeseed, pomace, and so on. So it is crucial, for instance, in the maize for crows, shredlich, and it's about high quality feeds. We are producing about 20,000 tons of feed. And I think this is one of the most important things. Then, of course, we may have different opinions about it, but more than half, 70 to 80 cubic meters. Are used in the biogas plant. We are producing 4,500 of megawatt hours in Petrovice, 6.5 megawatt hours. So, speaking about the biogas plants, so they are working 24 hours a day. They are not depending on sunshine or rainfall and so on. So what I really think it's very good, it's so-called bio sowing maize using strip-till technology and so on. Our entire company focuses on precise agriculture. So if you know our area, Mid-Moldau River, we have to cope with the landscape. And then, of course, we focus on water retention in the soil. For instance, strip till anti-erosion technology in maize or simply applying buffer zones and so on. If we lose the water, then it flows to Moldau River and then further it flows to Germany. But using the strip till technology, we manage to retain the water in our soil. And it's anti-drainage system and so on. Of course, I understand something is important, but I feel that in our area where we have really diverse landscape, it is not necessary to apply any other landscape elements. We just should maintain it correctly. And what is also very important is to focus on the carbon footprint. Everybody talks about it. The theory, about 3 to 4 years ago, I was in France, and they were constantly explaining to me that our big farms are generating the ozone hole in the climate. Based on that, we have initiated measurement of the carbon and methane. generated by agriculture. I just wanted to highlight one thing because nonsenses are really published. Everybody can look at the study of the University of California, Professor Frank Mitloner, where he clearly explains what is the carbon and methane released from animals that, of course, gets back to nature by photosynthesis, so no ozone hole, while fossil fuels, they clearly generated. Everybody can look at this study, and I think you can read a lot of scientific reports and so on describing the truth. And it is necessary to be open. We had, for instance, the permissions system. Currently, it is transformed into emission permissions, and now we call it so-called carbon offsets. I have to say that carbon offsets started to be traded. Banks started to trade with carbon offsets. Chains are also monitoring the carbon offsets. They wanted to prove once they import vegetable from Spain, but with the carbon footprint zero when they buy the carbon offsets. We already have companies suggesting once you deposit more organic material into the soil, we will use it for the carbon offset and we will sell it. They are really interested in that. So this is exactly what we are constantly discussing about it. It's about the farm-to-fork strategy, because if we truly apply it in practice, we would restrict the transportation and carbon footprint. It is necessary to consider the scientific truth. Unfortunately, nowadays, who has money, they are buying the carbon offsets and they would declare carbon footprint zero, even though it must be clear that it is not true. Even the large airlines, they are declaring it. For instance, British Airlines, they are declaring that by 2030 they will have zero carbon footprint because they will plant 2,000 trees or something like that. So this is quite clear that it is losing its intention. We try to to apply it in practice. It was a project funded by the Ministry of Agriculture from the Research Institute of Agriculture Technology. So, in fact, we just measured the ammonia, methane, and nitrous oxide levels. We just measured in the stalls in Krasna Lipa. I just wanted to be clear, farms in the Czech Republic that in fact use timeline for the entire year, they are decreasing the carbon footprint compared to animals on the pasture. So what they try to say, that large stalls are destroying climate, it's a nonsense. So this is really the way how they conducted the survey, combination of two feeds, Timar at one hand. It was produced in the Research Institute of Animal Husbandry in Uhříněvec. Also, about measurement of emissions. It was clearly seen that by feeding Timar compared to grazing animals, we achieve decreased CO2 levels, and this is necessary to publish it. It's true. So I would like to highlight that it is necessary, and it was suggested several times already, it is necessary to publish correct information, but it's quite clear that cattle it's really necessary for enriching the soil. It is not destroying the environment. We only have to consider the expert opinions. And vice versa, cattle breeding increases water retention in landscape and increases the environmental condition and living condition. So thank you very much for your attention.
I hope that Mr. Zelenka is connected in Krásná Hora. And the question is, do we have sufficient number of experts who will provide for qualified economy in future? Qualified management in future. I see him now. It's a good question. I think so, but unfortunately, I think that schools should improve in some matters. But I think what will matter is how the educational system will be developed and how we were able to engage young people. There's difficult to say more about that. Question to Mr. Zelenka, what kind of erosion prevention measures do you use in your agricultural farm in actually growing maize for silage purposes? I think that Mr. Zelenka mentioned that, but it might be useful to repeat it. I would like to answer this question because we have been dealing with this for 5 or 6 years, having it as a task. We had a system in subsoil, the intercrops seeding, and I can recommend clearly that on strongly eroded areas you can use new forms of seeding, seed planting, and this is what I talked about. Because it retains water and actually maize gets the roots of the maize gets enough sufficient water. Question to Mr. Zelenka. In the connection with the energy crisis and growth of prices of fossil fuels, what do you expect will be the development of industrial fuels, especially NO fuels? So it's about nitrogen fertilizers. So there is a direct connection, energy and gas, and also fertilizers. I think that the price of fertilizers is climbing to such amounts at the present time that agriculture will have to consider how it can be used, what purposes, and I will say that the domestic production will be used more, so we need for domestic cattle, like in form of manure, etc.